Welcome to another episode of GeekOutdoors.com. So Warrior Nun is a Netflix original series, and this is based upon a comic book. And so the general story is there is this ongoing battle between heaven and hell, and in the middle of it is this secret organization called the Warrior Nuns. And basically their entire mission is to protect humanity from the demons of hell. And in that mix, we have this girl named Ava, who just happened to be brought back to life through some very heavenly powers. And now we have our Warrior Nun story. So getting into the things that I did like about this series is this entire world building. Just the concept of these badass warrior nuns fighting demons, that's a really cool concept. And then another thing that I like about it is this whole organization, you know, this secret group of warrior nuns all around the world who have been protecting humanity for years. And in that mix, we have some really cool warrior nun characters, which leads me to the second best thing about the series are the warrior nuns themselves. Each one of these main warrior nuns that we meet, they have each of their own characteristics and, more importantly, backgrounds. I love everybody here from Shotgun Mary to Lilith, Beatrice, and there's another one I can't remember her name. And of course, Ava is the new warrior nun, but there's also other characters like Mother Superion and also Father Vincent. And so the characters here in the whole warrior nun world, I think they are very interesting overall. And then the final thing I did enjoy about this is whenever they did have action with the warrior nuns, I did enjoy it. And this was something that I was really hoping for, especially whenever I saw the trailers. It just looks like some badass warrior nun ninjas. And so whenever those moments happened, it was really cool. For serious YouTubers, check out TubeBuddy, the premier tool news at geekoutdoors.com. Get more done today by checking out the affiliate link in the description area below. Now, getting to the things that I did not like about this series is the whole story itself. You know, besides this awesome world, this lore that has been established and kind of been built, most of the story has this combination of Ava, fish out of water, teen angst story, and then we have the whole warrior nun story. And there's 10 episodes in this. And unfortunately, I would say 5 of the episodes for sure, it's all about Ava, you know, becoming alive again and trying to live a life that she missed. Now, that part I understand, and this part you understand more as you know her background, but the thing is, they dragged it out to like 5 episodes, and I think the worst part is they introduced these other side characters and a love interest for her, and they really just took me out of the entire story. So every time it went to that part of the story, I was so bored, and I just couldn't wait to get back to the warrior nuns and the whole lore behind it, because I really feel that's the best part of this entire series. And all that other stuff, even though it makes sense for them to establish Ava because she is the main character and kind of what she's going through, I think they could have done that within 2 episodes instead of spreading it out to 5 episodes, and it really slowed everything down. And so the overall story itself, it seemed like 2 stories to me. And I would much prefer just it focusing on the warrior nun story. That was a lot cooler. And then the second thing I didn't enjoy as much is the main character. Now, maybe this doesn't have anything to do with the actress. It might be just the way it was written. But Ava herself, she's the least interesting character out of all of them. And she's supposed to be the main character. And there was really never a moment, except for maybe some of her backstory, that it really felt a connection to her. More than anything, she just felt like an annoying character, you know, and you see that as you see the entire series. You know, she's always has these narrations of thoughts and having these jokes that just fall flat. And I don't know, she's just not a very likable character overall, especially when you contrast that against the actual warrior nuns, you know, the existing ones. They have such cool characterizations. They have, I think, a lot more mysterious and deep background. And at the same time, they just work really well together, whereas Ava just felt, you know, out of place. Let's just say that. And it wasn't until the end that Ava kind of started coming into her own. But still then, I still preferred the other warrior nuns and, you know, the overall lore more than I did her. And then a final thing that I really didn't enjoy about this series is the overall ending, okay? Now, I will say, out of all the 10 episodes, I did enjoy the 10th episode the best. It revealed a lot of things, which was really cool. We really got into the warrior nun and action, but the way it ended it off, it wasn't satisfying. It was basically setting it up for season 2, and you'll see what I mean by that. And I think it would have been a lot better if maybe this last episode was maybe like the 8th episode. So they had a little bit of time to tell a little bit more about what we discovered. And then leave it at a point where even though you're still wanting more, you still learn more about this whole warrior nun world as well. And so I think that would have been a better, more satisfying ending to this 10 episode series. So that is it for my review of Warrior Nun Season 1. Overall, at least for me, I thought it was an okay series, and if they would have just not spent so much time the first half of the series on the other stuff that I talked about and spent more time in this really cool warrior nun heaven versus hell type world, I would have enjoyed that a lot more. So maybe that's something we'll get in a season 2 if it does get future seasons. So that is it for my review of Warrior Nun. If you have seen this and you had any thoughts of your own, be sure to leave that in the comments area below. And if you wanted to see more of my sci-fi reviews, I will leave a playlist in the description as well. So as always, if you did get value out of these videos, be sure to share, like, and subscribe. Hey geeks, if you are a creative geek like me, and you wanted to learn how to create content on YouTube and other places on the internet, then check out my Go Content Creators Group, where you'll get access to additional videos and content for all the creative geeks out there. And the best part of it is, all of this is free. Simply head over to the link below, check out my page, and sign up for my Go Content Creators Group. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the other side.